I am Santiago Cervinho. I'm one of the people working in the Econos project. And what we are, I'm going to present now is the work of the Econos project related with the European HEIC, developing of the assessment model and information that we are using. So the first thing we're going to see is why we need this project, what is the real problems now with the HEIC assessment, particularly the biological problems. Then we're going to have a quick view to the Bayesian model, and also a fast view to the HEIC biological knowledge developed in Econos. And finally, we are going to concentrate more in the development of priors based on life history invariants and hierarchical meta-analysis. So first of all, we have to... There is not a pointer or something like that.
Unfortunately, I haven't seen one here. Okay. Yeah, you have one.
Well, everything is there. So in the ICS area, we have two different HEIC stocks, the northern and the southern. The northern is currently assessed with a length-based model called SS3. So the fishery is modeled quarterly, with since 1978, with 60 length groups. We are using seven fleets, and for the surveying model, we are using four surveys. The biological part of the model was implemented outside of the model and was estimated without so much information. Basically, what we have now is island infinity defined in 130 centimeters, a K parameter for the Bomberta lanthi, a natural mortality set equally for all years and lengths based on Hewitt and Honey in 0.4. And the reproduction here is the only information that we have observed, that is the maturity. We have information on maturity. We don't have observations on growth or natural mortality, but we have observations on maturity. And finally, the recruitment is modeled at a Shackleton Holt with a steepness near to one and high coefficient of variance. Basically, it's to say something that say that we have a mean recruitment estimate, without any stop recruitment relationship. The important thing is that the maturity information is the only information that we have observed. So with these biological problems, in the Econos project, what we like to do is to develop a Bayesian assessment model to improve and develop biological knowledge, and specifically to develop priors for the Bayesian assessment model. So the approach is for the assessment model. The assessment model is the same that was described. It's the GPDM, but the first task we have to do is to adapt this model to the HEIC case study. So we have to develop fishing selection processes. We have to develop subencalibration processes. You have to develop discard estimation processes. Discards is important in this stock, but we don't have discards every year, so you have to estimate the discards for the years without data. And the initial idea is to replicate as far as possible the current ICES model in a Bayesian framework. So use as much as possible the same assumptions, just to use it as a reference. And it's in the biological side. Basically, we are to improve our knowledge in growth, reproduction, natural mortality, and also to develop biological informative priors. So this is a schematic view of the HEIC implementation of the GPDM. Basically, what we did was implement all the processes that was mentioned. Apparently, the model works perfectly, at least in the process implemented, but we're having problems with the model that mainly are convergence problems. At the beginning, we have a lot of convergence problems, and the main problem is that every decision takes quite a lot of time. So the model runs really slow, so we need to simplify the model at the beginning, just to reduce the number of years, to reduce play with different length classes, and to accumulate different fleets. and also to simplify the priors and the processes. And also you used you had access to the fast computers in the CISGA is the center of supercomputation of Galicia. So we are using really fast computers, but even though the problem continues, now at this time approximately I've evaluated 50 runs. These are not so much because it's approximately 2 years of work, the equivalent 50 runs. And we were playing with different aggregation, basic, but you were not able to increase the number of years. We started to play with 10 years, and the model only has 10 years. But we play with different length groups, different fleets groups. After simplified processes and priors, we get a better convergence. But okay, we are having the model has improved quite a lot, but every step is slowly, so it's not finished. It's not already finished. Regarding to the biological knowledge developed along the Knowles process, I have to highlight that Hake produced a higher amount of eggs, larger Hake produced a relatively high amount of eggs, and we evaluated the impact of the of this higher fecundity on reference points. And we have seen that, for example, the impact of consider the egg production is different if you consider proxies for MSY, like if you consider the full MSYs based on stock recruitment relationships. So you have different impact. This is something to implement in the model, but not yet. We also, when we look at sex dimorphic species, we can see that not all of them, the sex ratio at length is not 50-50. It changes depending on the size. It changes depending on the age. So these changes are caused by different life history. What we are using is that this information as a basis to develop to improve the growth and the natural mortality estimation of the hake, just as a new livelihood in a sex-separated models. However, we are not in conditions to implement more complexity to the model. So this is a thing that we like to implement in the model, but not right now. So what we're looking now is at the biological priors based in the life history invariants. So life history theory aims to explain the reproductive success of a population based on the allocation of resources to the competing process of growth, reproduction, and survivorship. So if a population decided to start to reproduce at a given length, after that, obviously, it has a cost in terms of growth. If the population decided to delay the reproduction and continue growing, perhaps this population has a more potential to produce more eggs. However, it is alive, so there is a cost in survivorship. So these processes there are some trade-offs, and these trade-offs shaping what is called life history invariants. Life history invariants are amounts that properties of the population that are relatively constant. So Beaverton and Holt was the first to see empirically this behavior, and Carnot later explained theoretically why this happened. So in this work, we're playing with three different invariants. One is the relation between K and natural mortality. Other is the relationship between length of maturity and length infinity. And then the other one is the correlation between L infinity and K. So the idea is to develop a hierarchical meta-analysis to, starting with information that you have, that length of maturity, build data for the other parameters. So the idea is to use the hierarchical meta-analysis to estimate these invariants, length infinity, correlation between length infinity and k, and using the existing information on length and maturity with simple maths, just develop the information of the parameters that you need for stock assessment, that are growth and natural mortality. So the hierarchical approach allows to model in the dependence among parameters through the use of a hierarchical model structure. This is important because the life history invariants are more similar depending on the hierarchical of the taxonomic group. So are more similar among populations than among species than among genus. So the hierarchical model allowed to take in consideration this structure. So instead of using all the data combined for different sources, the system estimates parameters simultaneously at the species at the genus level and allowed to account for difference between species, giving higher weight to the data from the species that were interesting. In this case, is the European hake, and allowed to predict some parameters even if we don't have information on one particular species. So the information that we are using are the information for different species of hake all over the world. So there are in total 12 different species, and we had access to information through the fish base and also to a literature review. At the beginning after the literature review, you had 322 records for these different species, but after some screening, for example, using the phi parameter is a combination of the K and the L infinity, we reduced the amount of parameters. We also had to delete a lot of information from hake, European hake, because of most of them was based on a wrong growth. The current view of the hake growth of European hake have changed after the year 2000, so most of the information was not valid. So finally, we only get 241 records. Not all of them have information for all the parameters. So the first variant we are going to estimate is the relationship between length and length of maturity. At the beginning, you have 33 parameters with different amount of parameters in different species. But we also realize that one of the species has a quite different behavior in terms of the relationship between L infinity and length of maturity. Merluccius australis mature really late compared with the other species in size and grows just a small amount after the maturity. So we decided to delete the Merluccius australis. And with the hierarchical model and with information available, we developed the first prior for the L infinity, the relationship between L infinity and length of maturity.
3 bits.
Okay. Then we did the same with the relationship between L infinity and K. So basically, in this case, it's not a simple mean, it's just a linear model in log scale. In this case, we developed the posteriors for the K based for the hake for the K of European hake based on the L infinity that we estimated before. And after that, with this K, we did the same thing to estimate natural mortality. In this case, as you can see, there are not records with European hake. So in this case, the posterior for the European hake natural mortality is just based on the global information, not on the hake information. So with the information available on length of maturity for the two stocks, the northern and the southern hake, we develop a distribution for the length of maturity. And then after that, with simple maths, that is just multiply and getting the posteriors that are going to be the priors for the implementing the model for the length L infinity for the K for both stocks and for the natural mortality. Here you can see, for example, that the natural mortality that you are using for the current models, 0.4, is quite high, that the natural mortality that produced our analysis. But however, we have to think that our analysis that give the 0.4 was based on an assumption that all the mortality happens equally for all the ages. And in this case, this analysis estimated the natural mortality for the mature fish. So fish matures approximately after 40 centimeters. Okay? So basically, you consider that the smaller fish has higher natural mortality, perhaps this 0.4 is not really totally wrong. So as conclusions, have to say that this is an example of what we can do with a few information, biological information. If you have other information and theory coming, other information coming from literature and for other species, and this information allows to implement and improve the biasing assessment models with in two different ways. One provides priors for growth and natural mortality, but also provides prior for the invariants. The invariants, in some way, correlate the relationship, the trade-offs between the different life history processes. And this approach might also be helpful outside of the assessment of the Bayesian models. Can help to develop information for data pool stocks, to develop also biological scenarios to implement sensitivity analysis that takes in consideration the trade-offs between the life history processes, and also, for example, to validate assuming values for natural mortality. Thank you very much for your attention.